lot of science fiction, the advanced weaponry takes the form of guns firing directed bursts of plasma. These searing bolts of fire are classic ways to create weapons apparently rooted in science, but still fantastical and mysterious. After a quarter century of research and enough failed exotic weapons to fill a museum, the Pentagon has built upon its myriad failures to create skulls, or elaborately called as scalable compact ultra-short pulse laser system. It's a non-lethal weapon, more akin to Star Trek's fictional phaser, with the ability to warn, dazzle, defeat, stun or burn, depending on how you tweak the settings. It's a promising sign for the armed forces who want an effective weapon that won't kill, and a cause for concern for others who fear it becoming another instrument for torture. Mantras mentioned in its third mandal of Rigveda are associated with the Rishi Vishwamitra and his father. Vishwamitra composed the 12th mantra, which in verse 6 contains an intriguing description of 90 cities being destroyed simultaneously by one ultimate weapon used by Indradev. In Mahabharata, Arjun used this weapon against Angarparna. Rig Veda describes this weapon as Indragni, that is, the weapon which has the power of both Indra and Agni. Ancient Hindu texts describe Indra as the force of kinetic energy of subatomic particles that ignites and kindles, whereas Agni is described as fire, which is both thermonuclear and electric. Modern physics states that plasma is an electrically conducting medium in which there are roughly equal number of positively charged and negatively charged particles. It is produced when the atoms in the gas become ionized. In the same manner, combination of both Indra, the kinetic energy of highly mobile subatomic particles, and Agni, thermonuclear electric conducting medium, forms plasma. This plasma was exponentially amplified by heat and sound that was used as a weapon to simultaneously disintegrate the 90 cities. The technical name used for plasma in Rigveda is Soma. Indragni weapon uses laser-induced plasma channel, which is formed when a laser emits a laser beam into the air. The laser beam rapidly heats and ionizes surrounding gases to form plasma called soma. The plasma forms into an electrically conductive plasma channel. Because a laser-induced plasma channel relies on ionization, gas must exist between the electrolaser weapon and its target. If a laser beam is intense enough, its electric field is strong enough to rip electrons off the air molecules or whatever has happens to be in the between, creating plasma. The ancient rishis who composed the Rig Veda knew that space is not silent, and that it is made of plasma. The Rig Veda contains descriptions of such sciences. Plasma waves and sound waves are both waveforms, and it is possible to convert one into the other and vice versa. This is the reason ancient astras were invoked just by simple Vedic mantra. Sound waves gets converted into plasmic channel, which further detonates or evokes the astra. For more videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.